2008, things were really beginning to take off for Major League Soccer. In the previous year, in 2007, David Beckham had actually signed for the LA Galaxy, raising the reputation of not only the LA Galaxy, but Major League Soccer as well. There were also two new expansion franchises that were coming in upcoming years. In 2009, Seattle Sounders would later join, and Philadelphia Union were announced to join as well in 2010. There was also much more financial instability in the league, which was a far cry from 2001, just 7 years before 2008, when both Florida teams, the Miami Fusion and the Tampa Bay Mutiny, were folded due to various reasons, but there was an aspect of that being, you know, financial instability in the league. Things were starting to get better, and there was a lot more confidence that this league was here to stay. So MLS was looking for expansion candidates in MLS in 2008, and there were a lot of contenders, seven official ones, as well as two potential ones that really didn't seem to come to fruition, those two being Las Vegas and New York. The seven official contenders were Montreal, Ottawa, St. Louis, Atlanta, Portland, Vancouver, and an interesting team proposed in Miami, led by some even more intriguing investors, and that's the team that we're talking about today. While teams like Portland Timbers or Vancouver had history on their side, this team proposal for Miami did not. In fact, they had the opposite. This was because there had already been a team in MLS prior that existed back from 1998 to 2001 and ultimately died because of a lack of fan and corporate support. That team was the Miami Fusion. If MLS was going to put another team back in Miami, they would need to knock this bid out of the park. And boy, they tried. In came Brightstar Corporation CEO and owner of Bolivian club FC Bolivar, Marcelo Claure, multiple Miami Dade officials, and FC Barcelona president Juan Laporta on October 15th, 2008, vying to get an MLS franchise. Yes, you heard it right. FC Barcelona were looking at bringing a team to the US to put a team in Miami.
Now this bid is absolutely crazy. Just think about all the players who could have signed. Just some players that I'm thinking of. I mean, Xavi could have signed. Let's keep in mind he almost signed for New York City FC back in the day. Maybe Thierry Henry, instead of moving to New York Red Bulls, he would have moved to Barca Miami, because let's remember, before New York Red Bulls, he actually played for FC Barcelona. So maybe that Barcelona affiliation would have made him a bit more comfortable to move to Miami instead of New York. There's endless possibilities with this team, and that's what makes this team so exciting.
They were planning to play out of a 20,000 capacity stadium at Florida International University named FIU Stadium. Quick note, this stadium is currently named Ricardo Silva Stadium as of making this video, as it was renamed in 2017 until 2022 after Ricardo Silva, owner of Miami FC of the USL Championship, donated a significant amount of money to improve the stadium. From what it looks like, it seems as if they were planning to play out of the stadium for the foreseeable future. Potentially, they would build a new one in the long term. Barca Miami had agreed a 5-year deal with Florida International University with an option to leave the stadium in 3 seasons. They would proceed to share some of the revenues from various events hosted by Barca Miami in the future. FIU would also get some money to fix their stadium as a charitable donation, because the stadium was not in very good condition at the time. FIU Stadium was always a concern for MLS. In an age where MLS teams were beginning to get their own soccer-specific stadium, whether they were in the suburbs like Chicago Flyers' Bridgeview Stadium or in a city core like Toronto FC's BMO Field, teams that were willing to build their own stadium were always regarded more highly in MLS's book. The stadium wasn't all too amazing. I mean, it was a college football stadium that I believe was mostly bench seating, something that maybe may have been more acceptable back in the day when Columbus Crew Stadium was built in the late 90s, but was looked down upon at this point, and its artificial turf was in really poor condition.
The biggest issue with this expansion bid, oddly enough, was lack of support. Now you'd think that one of the most supported teams in the US, in FC Barcelona, if they would create an affiliate in Major League Soccer, the top division in the US for professional soccer, you'd think that it would succeed. But the Miami residents, they weren't too excited about this team. They weren't against it, but there weren't a lot of people who were showing support for the team. So that's what ultimately led to the demise of this expansion bid because there was an overall lack of support. Granted, this would be much lower quality than FC Barcelona, but I figure they probably could have signed some pretty exciting players. Maybe they would have brought some players from the B team. Maybe they would have brought some older players from the first team, and they could have played and had some pretty exciting football playing in Major League Soccer. This would have been a different type of team in Major League Soccer, but it never was to be. Even Miami FC, who were playing in the USL First Division at the time, they were not affiliated with this expansion bid, they were struggling, and they would eventually move to Fort Lauderdale, and actually, they would get rebranded to be named the Fort Lauderdale Strikers, which Fort Lauderdale, they're a northern suburb of Miami. So yeah, Miami FC wasn't doing too well, so I don't think that was exactly a vote of confidence as well for this expansion bid, and it definitely didn't help it. So overall lack of support for this bid was definitely not good.
In March of 2009, the expansion bid was pulled, citing the economic conditions that the 2008 global financial crisis presented. But let's remember, the economy in the US crashed in September, while the expansion bid was first announced in October. So if the economic conditions were looking that bad, they would have scrapped the bid probably even before announcing it. The real reason seemed to be because of a lack of general support from people in the area. Don Garber described it best when he said, "We didn't see a lot of internet buzz, a long list of people interested in buying season tickets or tapping into the Miami website. In the end, we're not convinced this can be a passionate MLS market right now."
Now those are some harsh words from Commissioner Garber, but they're definitely true ones. And let's also remind ourselves that, you know, this may have been a good thing because there was also a team in MLS at the time named Chivas USA. And at the time in 2008, wasn't getting the most support. It was founded in 2005, but it wasn't doing too bad. But we'd later find out in 2014, when we were averaging about 7,000 fans per game, and many of those tickets were getting given away, that this type of team wasn't too successful. And the reason why I'm saying this type of team is that I think Barca Miami would have been a similar type of team to Chivas USA. The reason why I say that is, think about Chivas USA's name. Think about the aspect of putting Chivas in your name. Chivas gives you a clear affiliation to Chivas Guadalajara. And one of the main problems that led to Chivas USA's failure, and this was just one part of it, but this was definitely a major part, was that name. When you affiliate yourself with a team in another country, especially when fans are very passionate about that league, you start alienating all the fans of other teams in that league. So if you're a Club America fan, maybe you're inspired to cheer for the LA Galaxy because of the Chivas Guadalajara fans supporting Chivas USA. So that kind of problem with that kind of branding issue when you affiliate yourselves too closely with another team in another country. And I think the same problem could have happened with Barcelona. Maybe Real Madrid fans would have started supporting another team. Perhaps once Orlando City came around, they would have started supporting Orlando instead of Miami because it had that strong affiliation with Barcelona. So I think that could have been a similar problem. I don't think it would have been as bad, but I think it could have been a similar problem. And another problem with Chivas USA was that when it was originally founded, this continued this problem, but it was really bad when it first started out, was they sent a lot of the B team players from Chivas Guadalajara to play for Chivas USA. So it was very clear right from the start that Chivas USA was a B team. And it really felt, you know, people don't want to cheer for a B team. They want to cheer for the original team, and you can be affiliated with that team, but they don't want to feel like they're just cheering for a development team. They want to feel like they're cheering for a team that's kind of on its own, has its own identity. I think a problem that could have happened with Barca and Miami is that they may have started sending some of their B team players from FC Barcelona B, and then people would have been like, I was expecting to see players like Xavi or something playing for this team, but yet now I'm just watching some B team players who I probably will forget about tomorrow. You don't want to feel like you're supporting a B team. You want to feel like you're supporting a team of its own identity. And I think that's a problem that could have happened with Miami.
The FC Barcelona CEO, Juan Oliver, stated that the US market continues to be a priority. However, no team has come to fruition since then,
while other teams like Manchester City's ownership have dipped their toes into the market, becoming part owners in New York City FC. So I have a feeling they're not bringing a team in the near future to the US. At the end of that process of choosing expansion team, Vancouver Whitecaps were announced on March 18th, 2009, while Portland Timbers were announced 2 days later. Marcelo Claure would continue to work in bringing an expansion franchise to Miami, eventually ending up becoming one of the major players in bringing MLS to Miami with Inter Miami, as he is one of the owners and current chairman of the team.
And I just want to say, what do you think about this expansion bid? Do you think it would have been successful? Leave all your thoughts about this video in the comments down below. I just want to say, I think this bid would have been unsuccessful. It would have been amazing. It would have been an amazing part of MLS history, but I just don't think it would have been very successful because of that strong affiliation with Barcelona, and I have a feeling they would have made the same mistakes as Chivas USA, and I think they would have sent a lot of B-team players from Barcelona down to this team, and I just think it wouldn't have been attracting many fans to the games, especially when they didn't even have a lot of support in the first place for the expansion bid. So if you're not even starting out with a lot of support in the first place, you know, how are you gonna succeed in the end? Thank you for watching this video. Please like this video if you enjoyed it, and subscribe if you want to see more content similar to this. I also made 7 videos previous to this video about soccer history in Miami, so you should check that out. I put a link in the description to that Miami area soccer history playlist. Anyway, that's about it for this video, and until next time, see ya.